I didn't decide to be an astronaut until I was finishing up my master's. I always liked engineering. I knew I wanted to do something in that field, and I got a degree in engineering physics as an undergraduate, and I went on and decided to try with computer science. And when I was getting out of that, though, I realized I probably needed to get a job at some point. That was probably the goal of going to school. And so I started thinking about really what I wanted to do at that point, you know, specifically in engineering and in that area. And and somehow the astronaut thing popped up in my head. I don't know what exactly it was that made it go in there. 11 years later, I finally made it. It was definitely well worth it, though. Well, not a whole heck of a lot. I was working at JSC already in the aircraft operations department. So that, I didn't have to move houses. I didn't have to do much else. I just changed over jobs. And I mean, yes, my day-to-day job changed quite a bit. Now I'm going back to school, really, because we have almost a year and a half, 2 years worth of basic training between the shuttle and the station. So that's what you go back and start studying again. But besides that, family life didn't change a bit. Nothing else really changed. You feel more protected, I believe, inside the spaceship. In the window, of course, you don't get a full view, more of a 360-degree kind of view you get in a spacesuit. So, of course, I haven't been up since the cupola's been there, so that's a different story. I'd like to find out how that is. But it definitely is a different view. It's a great view, though, from the shuttle itself and from station windows. It's fantastic. You can sit there and look out for hours. But it's just at another whole level to it when you do it in a spacesuit, and you're just in your own little space vehicle. You got this great view. You can look from horizon to horizon without much effort, and it's just you out in space. It's kind of a very interesting feeling. We call it a myriad of feelings come on you at the time. One, you have to get your job done, so you really concentrate on that too. But then you look down and see this beautiful Earth, and that kind of is a little overwhelming in itself. And then you realize, well, I'm in a vacuum too, which is a little dangerous, So there's many feelings going on at the same time. But I think the one that overrides everything, of course, is get the job done, because you don't want to screw up. I mean, everybody tells you how great it is to go to space. And then when you get there, it's even better. I think that's always, it's how much better it is than people even say. Because you never really believe them all. I say, yeah, you're just saying that just because, or you thought it was great to go and all that. And it is great to go. You think, yeah. When you get there, to me, it was just so much fun. The whole floating and doing everything like that and just working there, I just really, really enjoyed it. And I didn't realize how much I would enjoy it.